and welcome to MTV's news update for today, December 29, 2020. I'm Ashley Scotland. First, our top headlines. 2,000 house lots to be distributed in Region 6. Three new COVID-19 cases from 168 tests. Five senior councils admitted to the inner bar. And in sport, GFF plans to accelerate football development in 2021. Now for the news and details. Five senior councils were today inducted into the inner bar during a special sit-in of the full court of the Supreme Court of Judicia. Lone Williams reports.
The five appointed senior counsel Anil Nandlal, Timothy Jonas, Jamila Ali, Roy Stilford and Stanley Moore were today admitted to the inner bar during a special full court sitting of the Supreme Court of Judicature. Acting Chancellor of the Judiciary Justice Yonit Cummins Edwards, Acting Chief Justice Roxanne George Wilshire, Justice of Appeal Don Gregory and High Court Judges Brassington Reynolds and Narishwar Harnanand presided over today's special sitting in the High Court. The newly appointed Senior Counsel Anil Nandlal, Timothy Jonas, Jamila Ali were conferred the status of silk by President Dr. Irfan Ali, while Roy Stilford and Stanley Moore were appointed by former President David Granger. Acting Chief Justice Roxanne George Wilshire welcomed the Senior Counsel to the inner bar.
Congratulations to you, Mr. Stanley Alfred Moore, Senior Counsel, Ms. Jamila Aisha Ali, Senior Counsel, Mr. Timothy Monroe Jr., Senior Counsel, Mr. Roysdale Alton Ford, Senior Counsel, and Mr. Mohamed Anil Nandlal, Senior Counsel, and to your families and well-wishers. The judiciary formally welcomes your appointment as Senior Counsel. May God grant you continued wisdom and success. Thank you.
In the Commonwealth nations, the elevation to Senior Counselor Silk is conferred upon distinguished lawyers for exemplary contributions in the field of law. Upon conferment, the honoree is admitted a member of the inner bar of court. Since members wear silk gowns of a specific design, the counsels are usually referred to as silk. Luan Williams for MTV's News Update.
Minister of Health, Dr. Frank Anthony, said Guyana can now access the recently approved Inter-American Development Bank U.S. $30.4 million loan as part of continued COVID-19 response. He made this disclosure during Monday's COVID-19 update with the Department of Public Information. The loan falls under the IDB program, which supports minimum income levels and preserve the human capital of those affected by the pandemic. The loan was approved earlier this month. Dr. Anthony said while Guyana is poised to receive its first 20% of the COVID-19 vaccine through COVAX, funds will be used to prepare for the rollout. He said the funds will go towards the purchase of cold storage freezers as well as a cold chain for transporting the vaccines. The health minister explained that the personal protective equipment, PPE, utilized by healthcare workers, masks, gowns, face shields and shoe covers are disposed of after each use, and as such, these items would have to be procured in bulk. The IDB is also raising some US $1 billion to acquire and administer the COVID-19 vaccines in the region. The Guyana Agricultural and General Workers Union has welcomed the additional $4 billion approved for the Guyana Sugar Corporation to aid in the revitalization of the sugar industry. More from Celine Griffith.
The Guyana Agricultural and General Workers Union is pleased that the additional sum was approved to support the cash-strapped Guyana Sugar Corporation. The union, in a statement, said the sum which will be used to support capital expenditure comes at a critical time. The funds will be used to support the recapitalization of the operating estates Albion, Iflet and Blairmont. While the GAWU is heartened by the support, it urged that the monies now approved be properly and prudently utilized by the Sugar Corporation. The union is also urging that some level of investment be placed in the industry's workforce, which it deems as Gaisuko's most valuable asset. GAWU said the workers will play a sterling role in the reversal of the industry's decline, noting that they have persevered despite many adversities and continue to give of their best. At this time, GAWU and Gaisuko continue to remain in talks regarding the outstanding 2019 negotiations. For its part, GAWU has signaled a willingness to find a settlement and is prepared to listen to any reasonable proposal from the sugar company. Reporting for MTV's News Update, Celine Griffith.
More news coming up on the other side of the break.
It's the most beautiful time of the year. Lights fill the streets, spreading so much cheer. I should be playing in the winter snow, but I'ma be under the mistletoe. I
miss out on the holiday, but I can't stop staring at your face. I should be playing in the winter snow, but I'ma be under the mistletoe. With you, shawty, with you.
Good day. My name is Drapit Panya Sudden, and this is The Now. While living with HIV is no longer a death sentence, contracting HIV makes you twice as likely to contract other diseases, such as tuberculosis and coronavirus.
Stop this bus from putting out, man. Gotta this man and kill me back here, boy.
Persons can still receive their antiretrovirals even being at home. I know these individuals living with HIV are very worried about leaving and contracting COVID-19. It's important that they continue to use these medications even while battling COVID-19 to help fight off additional infections and to help strengthen their immune system.
For The Now, I am Drapit Panya Sudden.
For more information, call us on 592-227-8683 or 226-5371, extension 215.
Using Softex toilet tissue, available in leading supermarkets countrywide. Softex is always silky smooth because it's made from virgin pulp and babies love it. Softex comes available in single rolls, economy pack, six pack, and one dozen packages. Just perfect for any budget. Manufactured and distributed by BPATS Paper Manufacturing, Eccles Industrial Site. For more information, telephone 622-4197.
In the first 2 years, your baby will experience amazing growth in so many ways. To fuel it, they need the right nutrition. With Nestum, two servings of goodness a day provide the wholesomeness of carefully selected baby-grade grains, the additional iron that their brain needs to develop, and the yummy taste baby loves, assuring you the right nutrition in two servings. Nestum, it's all good, Mom.
Learn more online with Nestle Baby and Me.
This is MTV's news update. Welcome back. The National Assembly has approved a $17.4 billion supplementary budget to offset expenses, including additional funding for the $25,000 COVID-19 relief cash grant. More on this report.
An amount of $18.2 billion for this year was approved, totaling $792.3 million, drawn from the contingency fund with a $17.4 billion of supplementary provision. The additional sum of money was sought to cover both capital and current expenditures. The government had sought an additional $2.5 billion for payment of the $25,000 COVID-19 relief cash grant for households. Minister of Human Services and Social Security, Dr. Vindya Prasad, said the initial sum of $4.5 billion that was approved in the emergency budget was insufficient.
And you will appreciate that it was not sufficient because here I am asking for more money through the supplement.
Some $130 million was approved for the Ministry of Marine Affairs to purchase tractors for hinterland communities. Additionally, $6 billion was approved to facilitate payments for the advancement of the roads program, while $2 billion was approved for additional infrastructural works in the housing sector. Luan Williams from MTV's News Update.
Some 2,000 residents of Region 6 are set to become landowners through the Ministry of Housing and Water Central Housing and Planning Authority Dream Realized initiative. The two-day event is being hosted at the University of Guyana's Tain campus, currently in Berbice. Minister of Housing Colin Crowell and the Minister within the Ministry of Housing and Water, Susan Rodrigues, said the initiative is another step closer to achieving the PPPC's manifesto promise to provide sustainable housing for the nation. More than 1,000 Guyanese had received house lots during the Region 4 leg of the exercise, while another 1,500 house lots were distributed in Region 3. More than 153,000 households have so far benefited from the $25,000 cash grant as part of the government's measure to bring relief during the pandemic. More on this report.
Minister of Human Services and Social Security Dr. Vindhya Prasad said 9 regions are almost completed, with distribution ongoing in Region 4. She made this disclosure while presenting on the supplementary request in the National Assembly for $2.5 billion to continue the initiative. She explained that the additional funds being sought will supplement the $4.5 billion previously allocated to the first phase of the initiative. Minister Prasad said the first phase caters for primary households and to mop up any slippages in the disbursement, such as households that were missed.
It was the primary household that was intended for the first phase. Even if it's a home and they have 3 other households, they should receive the pink slips and they would be captured in the second phase of distribution.
To date, 8,124 households in Region 1 received their cash grants, 13,675 in Region 2, 44,097 in Region 3, 20,856 in Region 5, 35,009 in Region 6, 7,052 in Region 7, 3,064 in Region 8, 7,503 in Region 9, and 30,996 in Region 10. Additionally, some 16,075 pink slips or query forms have been filled out. These persons are expected to receive grants during Phase 2 of the initiative. Reporting for MTV's News Update, Celine Griffith.
Still ahead, 3 new COVID-19 cases from 168 tests, and GRE takes Atlantic Fuel Incorporated to court for making false declaration.
As a new mom, there are moments of pride, joy, and doubt. Yes, doubt. Has he slept enough? Does she have everything that she needs? Will she be okay in the sun? These doubts come from love. For the good of baby, 2 servings of Nestum are full of all the goodness and naturalness of the cereals that your baby needs to blossom. That's one less thing to worry about. Nestum, it's all good, Mom.
Learn more online with Nestle Baby and Me.
Planning a cleanup? We can help. Sevon's Waste Management skip bins can be provided for home renovation projects, yard cleanups, or construction sites. It's simple. Step 1, just pick up the phone and give us a call. Step 2, we deliver the skip bin size of your choice. Step 3, load the skip with all of your junk. And finally, step 4, we take it all away. It's that simple. Bins are also available in various sizes, so there's no job that's too big or too small. Call Sevon's Waste Management today at 218-1455 or 218-1156.
Shop at John Lewis Styles in December and you could win 1 Amazon Fire tablet every day. Yes, every day. And that's not all. 4 persons will win $500,000 to spend in the store. Just imagine, $500,000 to spend on clothing, footwear, watches, fragrances, handbags, luggage, and accessories. So shop now at John Lewis Styles to win 1 Amazon tablet every day and $500,000 to spend in the store. John Lewis Styles, simply different.
Modern Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for single vision lens and $12,000 for bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
Beeson Windows and Doors, fully equipped to handle all your commercial projects. Whether you're constructing a small or large commercial building, residential property, or just upgrading your home, they got you covered. Beeson Windows and Doors, providing unmatched quality windows for your home, office, and commercial building. Located at 1228 Eccles Industrial Site. For more information, call 662-4197 or 226-1292.
You're tuned to MTV's News Update. The Ghana Revenue Authority has recovered the images which were deleted from its scanner relating to a container of scrap metal which left Ghana last September for Belgium and was busted with 11.5 tons of cocaine. Here is Celine Griffith.
Home Affairs Minister Robeson Ben said the person is now the subject of parallel investigations with the Customs Anti-Narcotics Unit and the Guyana Revenue Authority.
There's some difficulty because over 50,000 images were provided to the KANU. They're trying nevertheless to examine them, but for sure it is known who removed the images, the dates and the times.
Meanwhile, head of KANU James Singh told the newsroom that the person was initially arrested early November along with three others. GRA managed to recover the images earlier this month. According to Commissioner General of GRA Godfrey Stacia, investigations found that an administrative passcode was used to delete the files. However, the passcode was used by multiple persons. Additionally, KANU continues the search for the local shipper Marlon Primo and has requested the assistance of international counterparts in an effort to locate him. KANU have also been receiving support from the Belgian authorities as it relates to the sharing of information regarding the seizure.
Belgians are proceeding with their investigations. There was a former head of the Belgian narcotics division who was being sought. Some examinations were recently made in other parts of the country in respect of trafficking routes. That's where we are at the moment.
The drug bust was dubbed the largest in the world with an estimated street value of 900 million euros. The illegal substance was disguised as scrap metal and placed inside a sealed container, packed into a sea container, and loaded into a transatlantic vessel. The shipment left Guyana on September 25 and was opened in Belgium on October 27. Reporting for MTV's News Update, Celine Griffith.
The Ministry of Health today said three new COVID-19 cases were recorded from 168 tests. This takes the total number of cases to 6,301. The death toll stands at 164. There are five active cases in institutional isolation and 348 cases in home isolation. A further 17 patients are in institutional quarantine. Seven persons are in the COVID-19 intensive care unit. The Guyana Revenue Authority has commenced legal proceedings against Atlantic Fuel Incorporated for allegedly making a false customs declaration. Here is Lewin Williams.
The Guyana Revenue Authority has taken Atlantic Fuels Incorporated to the court for allegedly making false customs declarations back in November. The Georgetown Magistrates Court has issued a summons for the fuel company on January 4, and a representative from the company is expected to answer the charges. The Atlantic Fuels Incorporated is owned by former Chief Executive Officer of Guyana Water Incorporated, Dr. Richard Van West Charles. The charge alleges that the fuel company on November 12 at Camp Street, Georgetown, caused to be made and subscribe a false declaration to the Revenue Authority, to which an invoice number 100 for customs declaration reference number GY410 was falsely declared contrary to Section 217(1)(a) of the Customs Act 8301. The Guyana Revenue Authority back in 2019 launched a similar probe into the fuel company over allegations of tax fraud. Atlantic Fuels was granted a license in late 2015, months after the coalition government took office. Luan Williams for MTV's News Update.
And now for tonight's edition of Health Tip.
Appendicitis is an inflammation of the appendix, a finger-shaped pouch that projects from your colon on the lower right side of your abdomen. Appendicitis causes pain in your lower right abdomen. However, in most people, pain begins around the navel and then moves. As inflammation worsens, appendicitis pain typically increases and eventually becomes severe. Symptoms. Signs and symptoms of appendicitis may include sudden pain that begins around your navel and often shifts to your lower right abdomen, pain that worsens if you cough, walk, or make other jarring movement, nausea and vomiting, loss of appetite, low-grade fever that may worsen as the illness progresses, constipation or diarrhea, abdominal bloating, flatulence. The site of your pain may vary depending on your age and the position of your appendix. When you're pregnant, the pain may seem to come from your upper abdomen because your appendix is higher during pregnancy. Causes. A blockage in the lining of the appendix that results in infection is a likely cause of appendicitis. The bacteria multiply rapidly, causing the appendix to become inflamed, swollen, and filled with pus. If not treated promptly, the appendix can rupture. Treatment. Appendicitis treatment usually involves surgery to remove the inflamed appendix. Before surgery, you may be given a dose of antibiotics to treat infection. Appendectomy can be performed as open surgery using one abdominal incision about 2 to 4 inches long, or the surgery can be done through a few small abdominal incisions called a laparoscopic surgery. During the procedure, the surgeon inserts special surgical tools and the video camera into your abdomen to remove your appendix. In general, laparoscopic surgery allows you to recover faster and heal with less pain and scarring. It may be better for older adults and people with obesity. But laparoscopic surgery is not appropriate for everyone. If your appendix has ruptured and infection has spread beyond the appendix, or if you have an abscess, you may need an open appendectomy, which allows your surgeon to clean the abdominal cavity. Expect to spend 1 or 2 days in the hospital after your appendectomy. Draining an abscess before appendix surgery. If your appendix has burst and an abscess has formed around it, the abscess may be drained by placing a tube through your skin into the abscess. Appendectomy can be performed several weeks later after controlling the infection. Lifestyle and home remedies. Expect a few weeks of recovery from an appendectomy, or longer if your appendix burst. To help your body heal, you can try these tips. 1. Avoid strenuous activity at first. If your appendectomy was done laparoscopically, limit your activity for 3 to 5 days. If you have had an open appendectomy, limit your activity for 10 to 14 days. Always ask your doctor about limitations on your activity and when you can resume normal activities after surgery. 2. Support your abdomen when you cough. Place a pillow over your abdomen and apply pressure before you cough, laugh, or move to help reduce pain. 3. Call your doctor if your pain medications are not helping. Being in pain puts extra stress on your body and slows the healing process. If you are still in pain despite your pain medications, call your doctor. 4. Get up and move when you are ready. Start slowly and increase your activity as you feel up to it. 5. Sleep when tired. As your body heals, you may find that you feel sleepier than usual. Take it easy and rest when you need to. 6. Discuss returning to work or school with your doctor. You can return to work when you feel up to it. Children may be able to return to school less than a week after surgery. However, they should wait 2 to 4 weeks to resume strenuous activity, such as gym classes or sports.
The ISG and MTV's sport update is next. Stay tuned.
Are you running around looking for construction materials? Well, run down to Lens for affordable, high-quality building supplies. We have the widest range of grade A floor and wall tiles in any shape, size, and designs. And all types of ceramics, porcelain glazed, and full body porcelain. We stock the largest collection of large format tiles. Check out our porcelain slabs as big as 10 feet by 4.5 feet. Add a bit of elegance with our large range of decorative molding. Our line of PPG paints will give you vibrant colors that won't fade. With our wall and ceiling gypsum system, it's light, durable, and fast. So come down to Lens at 136 Cherry Street, which is next to Buddy's and Pizza Hut, for that 31 years of Lens quality.
Are you having sore throat, fever, coughing, headache, or runny nose? Take Cetamol Cold and Flu day or night. Ask your pharmacist for Cetamol Cold and Flu and get back to the happier you.
Distributed by Massey Distribution.
Are you having sore throat, fever, coughing, headache, or runny nose? Take Cetamol Cold and Flu day or night. Ask your pharmacist for Cetamol Cold and Flu and get back to the happier you.
Distributed by Massey Distribution.
In the first 2 years, your baby will experience amazing growth in so many ways. to fuel it, they need the right nutrition. With Nestum, 2 servings of goodness a day provides the wholesomeness of carefully selected grains. Tailored nutrition to grow. And the yummy taste baby loves, complementing the proper nutrition in 2 servings. Nestum, it's all good, Mom.
Learn more online with Nestle Baby and Me.
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any 5 numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick pick for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
Get the right seal right now from Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc., your immediate SKF sealing solutions. The SKF seal jet machine is capable of building seals from 5mm to 600mm in diameter in under 5 minutes. With technical support readily available, you can get a customized seal to suit virtually any industrial application, like buffer, rod, wiper, and piston seals. SKF seal jet machine, now at Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc.
The Cricket West Indies selection panel has named West Indies Test and One-Day International squads for the upcoming tour of Bangladesh. West Indies are scheduled to play 3 One-Day Internationals and 2 Tests in a shortened tour. Craig Brathwaite will lead the Test squad, while Jason Mohammed will captain the ODI team. Chief Selector Roger Harper said, although a number of senior players are missing from both formats, he expects the team to play with purpose, passion and desire. The West Indies touring party are due to arrive in Dhaka on January 10, and the series will run until February 15. The full Test squad reads Craig Brathwaite, Jermaine Blackwood, Nkrumah Bonner, John Campbell, Rakeem Cornwall, Joshua Da Silva, Shannon Gabriel, Kevin Hodge, Alzari Joseph, Kyle Myers, Shane Mosley, Virsami Permal, Kimar Roach, Raymond Reefer, and Jamel Warrican. On the other hand, the ODI squad reads Jason Mohammed, Sunil Amras, Nkrumah Bonner, Joshua Da Silva, Jamar Hamilton, Jamar Holder, Akil Hussain, Alzari Joseph, Kyle Myers, Andrew McCarthy, Kajorn Otley, Ravman Powell, Romario Shepherd, Raymond Reefer, and Hayden Walsh Jr. Jason Holder, Kyron Pollard, Darren Bravo, Shamar Brooks, Roston Chase, Sheldon Cottrell, Evan Lewis, Shea Hope, Sherman Hetmeyer, and Nicholas Puran all opted out due to COVID-19 concerns. Meanwhile, Fabian Allen and Shane Dowridge are unavailable owing to personal reasons. The CWI COVID-19 policy allows any player to opt out of selection for an overseas tour based on the player's own safety fears or concerns. Such decisions will not impact their consideration for future selection. Meanwhile, it has been a difficult year for all sporting disciplines, and for basketball it has been no different owing to the coronavirus pandemic. With the absence of play, the Guyana Amateur Basketball Federation took advantage of the opportunity to network and collaborate with peers and partners in multiple virtual meetings, clinics, and workshops. Members of the basketball fraternity attended clinics and workshops offered by the International Basketball Federation, the Central American and Caribbean Basketball Confederation, and the Guyana Olympic Association. A variety of topics were presented by experts across the world with focus on national federation development. GABF's first AGM was held with focus on implementing new strategic priorities, empowering sub-associations, women in basketball, and enlarging the GABF family. The association also signed a 5-year partnership with Genius Sports, valued at US$182,000, which will provide a digital platform for FIBA live stats, organizers, game center, and network. In 2021, the GABF intends to execute all canceled events in 2020, including the 3-on-3 basketball and youth and women's basketball. FIBA events for 2021 include the FIBA Basketball World Cup pre-qualifiers, FIBA 3-on-3 AmeriCup qualifiers, among others. We tell you now, It has been a challenging year for football in Guyana, with players not being able to take a ball to the pitch in almost a year. President of the Guyana Football Federation, Wayne Ford, said, even though the pandemic has affected the sport tremendously, the association is taking all steps necessary to restart competition in the safest possible way.
This is not in any way good for us. This affects the growth and development of some of our most talented and gifted players. And it affects the good and solid and sturdy partnerships we have been able to develop with our corporate friends.
In almost 12 months, there has been no competitive football being played since the onset of the coronavirus pandemic. Ford believes the Federation has a solid blueprint for the return and development of football in 2021.
Over these past months, the leadership of the GFF have gotten together with our member associations, our affiliates, and the leadership of the elite clubs. And I believe we now have in place a solid blueprint for the development of football in 2021 and beyond.
The Guyana Football Federation has partnered with UEFA and CONCACAF to launch a bounce-back program to resume football activities safely and responsibly. A two-day bounce-back football tournament will kick off at the National Stadium on December 29 to January 1. Finally, NBA champions the Los Angeles Lakers lost for the second time in their four opening games of the new season to the Portland Trail Blazers. BBC Sport reported the Lakers allowed Portland a 115-107 victory. Playing for the second time, the Lakers led 85-84 going into the quarterfinal at the Staples Center. Damian Lillard scored 31 points and was supported by Gary Trent Jr.'s 28 as Portland made it 2 wins from 3 matches. Meanwhile, the Detroit Pistons suffered a third defeat as the Atlanta Hawks made 3 from 3 with a 128-120 victory. Jerami Grant and Josh Jackson both netted 27 points for Atlanta. On the other hand, Nikola Jokic handed the Denver Nuggets a 124-111 win over the Houston Rockets. He scored 19 points, 18 assists, and 12 rebounds. For MTV's Sports Update, Chelsea Lee.
That brings us to the end of Sport Update, which was brought to you with the kind compliments of ISG. More after the break.
Welcome to Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc., Guyana's sole distributor of NP and Ultra Lubricants, SKF bearings, seal and belts, international trucks and parts, and Napa batteries. With a bond capacity of 30,000 square foot, we offer superior brands at affordable prices and the best after-sales service. ISG supplies sustainable integrated solutions to make your business a growing success. Visit us at our new main office at Lot 4Q, Peters Hall, ISG. The best opportunity to make the right choice.
And that brings down the curtain in tonight's newscast. But before we go, here is a reminder of our top stories. 2,000 house lots to be distributed in Region 6. 3 new COVID-19 cases from 168 tests. 5 senior councils admitted to the inner bar. And in sport, GFF plans to accelerate football development in 2021. Catch our broadcast tomorrow at 6:30. Don't forget to like our Facebook page, where the news can be viewed live at 19:30. On behalf of our news and technical teams, Ashley Scotland, saying stay safe and goodbye for now.